Configurable consolidation rules are deployed in Rulesets. The rules in Rulesets run during consolidation and create consolidation accounting entries using the elimination member of the consolidation dimension. You create Rulesets on the Consolidated tab of the Consolidation Process page. I'll create a Ruleset of rules for subsidiary entities that eliminates the subsidiary's consolidation amount from equity accounts, posts an offset for the subsidiary's percentage ownership, which represents the holding company's ownership share, to the goodwill account, and posts the minority interest ownership share to the minority interest account. You can add conditions that a data record must meet to be processed by the rule set. I want the rules to run only if the current entity's consolidation method is subsidiary and the data value is not zero. You can select from a list of commonly used conditions. You can use the advanced condition option to build complex conditions that use and, or, and not as connectors and can include grouping of condition expressions. The conditions you define apply to all rules in the rule set. You cannot override them for individual rules. The dataset specifies the member from which to retrieve the source data. By default, data is retrieved for the current POV selections for scenario, year, period, and entity. The consolidation member defaults to entity total, currency to parent currency, and view to periodic. You can use the member selector for a dimension to retrieve data from another member. For example, your adjustment may require data from a prior year or period. You can specify an offset for the period and year dimensions. You cannot select the member for the entity dimension. Data is always retrieved from the entity currently being consolidated. I'll accept the default dataset. The ruleset scope defines the members for which the rules in the ruleset are executed. You can add scope filters to limit the default scope. I want the rules in this ruleset to run only for level 0 members under total equity, so I'll add a filter for the account dimension, search for total equity, and then select level 0 descendants. I want to exclude the CTA account, the level 0 members of retained earnings current, and the level 0 members of other reserves, so I'll add an exclusion for these. You can include only level 0 members in scope filters. For intercompany, I'll select all level 0 members under intercompany top. For data source, I'll select all level 0 members under total input and adjusted. For movement, I'll select all level 0 members under closing balance and exclude opening balance. You cannot modify the dataset or the rule scope defined in the rule set in the individual rules. This helps ensure that the rules in the rule set create balanced entries by applying each rule against the same source data. You can optionally define a factor to be used by all the rules in the rule set. The factor is the percentage applied to the source value to calculate the amount posted to the elimination member. You specify whether to add or subtract the source value from the target point of view in the individual rules. The rules in this rule set have varying requirements for factor, so I'll leave it set to none here and define it in the rules. If you define a factor in the rule set, you cannot override it for individual rules. I'm finished working on this rule set, so I'll click Save and Close. For information on adding rules to rule sets, please see the Help Center video, Creating Rules for Configurable Consolidation. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.